What is up, you guys? In today's video, I'm going to show you how you can expand the background or features within any image using a brand new AI feature in Canva. I'm going to show you exactly how I was able to transform this image into this using Canva within seconds. So let me go ahead and hop into the computer and I'm going to show you exactly how I did this. There's no stopping me now. I know my right now you can see this is an image that I created using Bing, and the downside or drawback to using Microsoft Bing's image creator from Designer is it creates these square images, and sometimes you want like a 16:9 or a landscape image that you can use maybe for a background. So for example, I'm working on a very secret special project that I'm not quite ready to tell you guys about, but I want to transform this image into a 16:9. And if I were to expand it out, it would pretty much kind of crop out the image and I would have to cut off details. So I'm going to actually add this in Canva and have Canva use a tool to actually fill in the rest of the picture and image so that I can turn it into a 16:9. So in order to do that, I'm just going to save and download my image here. And then we're going to hop over to Canva. Okay, so now I'm in Canva and basically I just created a new landscape for me to add my image to. So I'm in an untitled presentation, which is 16:9 or same dimensions as a PowerPoint presentation. And the first thing that I want to do is upload my image that I downloaded from Bing Image Creator. We're going to wait for that to upload, and then we're going to drag it over to my canvas so that we can expand the background. And this tool is absolutely amazing. I'm so glad I discovered this. Thank you, Canva, for even creating this, because this is like really taking images and designs to a whole nother level. All right, now that my image is uploaded, I'm just going to drag it over here and I'm going to center this for how I want this to actually lay out. So for example, if I had a grid on here, let me go to grid. Let me move me over here. I feel like I'm in the way. So let me go to grid. So if I add a grid and then I add this image in the grid, you can see that when it expands it, it actually like cuts off the head. And then if I edit this to where I drag it down and I crop this, then it's like you're missing all the details. You can't see the journal and stuff on the desk. So that is why I want to basically expand the image instead of using grid, because there are a lot of details that I want to keep in this image. And I also want to flush out the rest of the room to add to the atmosphere. So I'm going to go ahead and delete this grid and then add my image back in there. And I'm going to try to place this to where I want the Canva AI to fill in the rest of the background. So I'm actually going to use this image for a, I'm thinking about creating a new YouTube series where I'm basically going to do like Dear Diary sessions. And I want to kind of have her writing in a journal and then animate this later. But I'm trying to get the vibe right first. So I think about right here is where I want this to be. So there'll be a little bit of space and room within the environment that you can see other places. So now that I have this position about where I want her to sit and where I want the desk, what I'm going to do is go over to edit photo, and then I'm going to hit right here where it says magic expand. And then basically what this is going to do is expand the background for the actual image. So it's going to fill in everything. So I'm doing expand and then I'm going to click on whole page. So even though this is only taking up this square, I want the image to fill in the rest of the page. And I'm going to hit magic expand. It's going to do a little bit of thinking and then it's going to generate four possible different fill-ins that it's doing using AI generation. So we're going to give this a minute to think. All right, there we go. So now we can see the different iterations that the Magic Expand has added for us. So this is the first option you see here. The other option is kind of like a square desk. And then the third option, I don't know that I like this one because there's this funky thing happening right here. I don't really know what that is, but I do like this over here. And let's see what the fourth. Oh, I really kind of like this fourth option. I like this fourth option, but I don't because it's like you can't see the end of the desk there. And it's like the journal is blending in with the rest of this. And that's not what I want. I kind of like this option, but I don't love it. I do like this first one, but I'm still not 100% satisfied. And the great thing that I love about this is if you don't like it, you can generate additional results. So I'm just going to say generate new results. And hopefully this time it gives me a background that I not only like, but I love. I think I like the third one. No, this is not hitting at all. Who is this lady? Why does she look like the Grim Reaper coming to claim my soul? Absolutely not, Canva. Absolutely not. That's a no on that one. I do like this one here. I like this one. I like that it added this lamp over here. And it has the laptop. Let's see. I like this one as well. I think what's really throwing this off is this little piece right here. But I'm not too upset about it, but I do like this one. I think I'm going to go with this one. So in order to keep the changes, all I have to do is just hit done, and then it will actually add that to my image. All right, so there you have it. That is how I am able to create and expand the background on any image within minutes using Canva's brand new Magic Expand feature. So go ahead, try it out for yourself and let me know what you create. As always, thanks so much for stopping by my internet home. Make sure you like and comment. And if you're new here, subscribe so you can be one of the first ones to get notified anytime I upload another video just like this. All right, bye y'all.